Hello, fabulous friends, fans, and superstars. Welcome to your horoscope for the week of July 19, 2020. I am your astrologer, Nadiya Shah. Thank you for being here. We will begin this week in the dark of the moon. Now, the ancients have spoken about the dark of the moon as an incredibly powerful time, a time when the mysteries and the more mystical side of existence becomes that much more evident, and when it is that we're able to work on things more privately that we hope to bring illumination to, well, this tends to be a time of special potency to these types of intentions. But it will be on Monday that we are going to have a new moon. Now, this will be a new moon in the sign of Cancer. If you think back, it was last month that we had a solar eclipse in the sign of Cancer as well. Now, a solar eclipse is essentially a new moon, but an especially powerful new moon, often happening close to the nodes of the moon in the sky. Now, I like to call this a jacked up new moon, but that's just my terminology. And so this is not a solar eclipse. This is just an ordinary new moon, but it is extraordinary in its own way. It is the second new moon to take place in the sign of Cancer, back to back, 28 and a half days apart. However, whereas last time the solar eclipse took place at 0 degrees at the very beginning of its respective sign, representing a sense of a true beginning, a purity of intention, if you will, it is now that this new moon taking place in an anorectic degree, in a late degree of its sign, that it brings with it a new beginning, as is inherent in a new moon, but also a sense of culmination as well. Now, this new moon is happening across the sky with precision with Saturn. Now, normally the sun stands across the sky from Saturn once every year. What sign the sun and Saturn are in, well, that can change. Certainly, it may be the same over a period of 2 or 3 years, but beyond that, it can change. However, what's different now is that the new moon is in the mix, making this aspect of the sun and Saturn that much more special to this time. Saturn standing across the sky brings with it some awareness of a harsh reality that some of us may need. It is taking stock of things more honestly and making a choice from that place. Now, sometimes it is possible to see things pessimistically with this particular aspect, and that's where self-care becomes that much more important. And I think that care is especially emphasized at this time. This is a new moon in Cancer, after all. Now, there are layers to understanding care, of course. There is the care we give to each other, the self-care we practice. Cancer has to do with how well we take care of each other, including and especially those people we consider our own, whether that is our own family, whether that is people with whom we share a certain basic identity. That could be an identity of ethnicity or of nationality. And so, as we see here with Saturn standing across the sky, there is this sense of taking into consideration what sacrifices are worth making and perhaps what aren't. There's a sense with this new moon of it coming with an ending as well, not only because of the anorectic degree that I mentioned, but Saturn can also speak to limits and reaching the limits of a matter. Now, I know that as of recently, as of the last few months, there have, of course, been in many countries some form of social care that has taken place, some forms of social security in terms of ensuring that people are able to maintain, that people are going to be well in light of the recent pandemic and the pandemic that we are still in the midst of. And so we have now this particular aspect, and it can speak to some places in the world feeling as if they perhaps have reached the limit of the social care that they are able to provide or willing to provide. And this may be a time when there are people who are likely going to feel as if they have reached a point where there is more evaluation in terms of understanding what sacrifices are worth it, what sacrifices are not, in terms of understanding the limits of what is possible, in terms of how care has been understood, and how that is going to continue or not. Now, of course, each country around the world has its own values. They have their own way of understanding this and living up to it. But we will see this week, and especially the first days of the week, serve as a turning point of sorts for many places out there. The other layer to what's transpiring now, though, is the fact that in the middle of the week, right around Wednesday, is when we are going to have a harmonious alignment between Mercury, currently in the sign of Cancer, and also Uranus. Now, this harmonious connection is the type of aspect that astrologers call a sextile. And it is one where we are able to set our intention and take a little bit of action and have that rewarded. It involves us needing to be active. And in this way, we have some measure of control. It's not that we're just sitting back and letting good things transpire or sitting back and feeling frustrated or powerless, but it's that we understand if we take a step, then we can be a part of creating momentum and have that rewarded to feel a sense of positive outcomes as a result of our effort. Now, if this alignment sounds familiar, it's because this is the third and final time that Mercury and Uranus will speak in this way as part of the larger Mercury retrograde season. Yes, we're almost done. In fact, it is going to be at the end of this week that Mercury will leave shadow. And this larger Mercury retrograde season that we have been in since early June will be good and behind us. So it was at the beginning of June that Mercury stepped into shadow. It was right around the 18th of June that Mercury went retrograde and stayed retrograde right to the 12th of July. That was when Mercury went direct. Well, now Mercury is retracing the steps that he's already traveled over twice. And this is the last little bit before Mercury is on brand spanking new ground and in a space of fresh energy. And what a way to begin that fresh energy with this aspect of Mercury and Uranus speaking to the new and the next and the exciting and yes, the fresh as well. Now, what I find interesting is that this entire Mercury retrograde season has been spent with Mercury in the sign of Cancer. As I said, we had a rare two new moons back to back in the sign of Cancer as well. And it's almost as if at this time and in this space, we as part of the wisdom of the unfolding of the universe have been asked to understand what it means to care within ourselves, for each other, more deeply than we have before, to consider identities like ethnicity, like nationality, with greater depth and greater nuance than we have before, to bring our emotional selves to our effort, to our lives, and to think about others. That is something that the Cancerian energy is known for. And this has been a wisdom, an impetus, an energy that has been calling us in a notable way over the course of the last few months in particular. And how it is that we have embraced that learning or embraced that call, of course, has been highly unique to each of us. And how we've come to understand these lessons has been unique to each of us as well. So now here we are integrating these lessons more deeply. The Mercury retrograde season certainly helped us. But if we look at it in a more immediate sense, and we look at it in the context of just this week, it is this energy of Saturn and the sun on one side with the new moon hand in hand, Saturn on the other, that has asked us to look at something responsibly with greater maturity where possible, to consider what's worth putting in the time, what's worth the sacrifice. And for some, this does represent a moment of a difficult reality needing to be accepted, right? It's a sense of a stark reality in some cases, whether we like it or not, and having to make an evaluation from that space. But Very quickly, the energy shifts in the same sign. We are going to have that beautiful connection of Mercury and Uranus. And it tells me that, yes, as we begin the week, there may be a tough decision. It may not necessarily be easy for us to navigate this time. All of us in at least one area of life are having to look at things more honestly, perhaps than we have in a while, and perhaps so honestly than we have been accustomed to seeing things. And in the process and in addressing things with greater maturity, the rewards will be there. This to me is turning point energy. When the sun stands across from Saturn, a decision is made. The new moon brings emotion and intensity to it as well. The late degree, anorectic degree new moon brings that much more energy and intensity to this time. But all of us in some way may be feeling like we are at a crossroads. And in honestly evaluating, making a decision, whether we are going to stay the course and the sacrifices are worth it, or we're going to go in a different direction. Now, regardless of what we choose, though, there is going to be some boost that finds us in a positive sense in the middle of the week. Now, Mercury speaking in harmony with Uranus on the surface, one of the most direct interpretations is good news. This is good news finding us in at least one area of life, and certainly for the collective as well. This can be a positive change of events that is rooted in information, conversation, and communication as well. This can be fresh perspectives, fresh insights, new understandings that change the way that we see things, change the way we are interpreting things. And this energy can also speak to how it is that making that tough choice early in the week is rewarded with positive outcomes, or at the very least, positive reinforcement in some way. So if it is that we decide to stay the course, it may very well be the case that we end up feeling a sense of a boost and positive reinforcement as a result. If it is that we end up deciding to change things for ourselves, well, this can be that sense of beginner's luck being with us. But if you've ever read the book The Alchemist by Paulo Coelho, in this book, he actually talks about this brilliant book. He talks about how in the beginning, when you first set yourself on a pathway towards achieving your dream, you will have that beginner's luck. And that is the universe's way of telling you that you're on the right path. And then what happens is challenges start to emerge. And the reason that the challenges emerge is because it is not about the dream. It is not about the achievement of the dream. It is about who you become in the process. And we become the best that we can be through navigating times of challenge and change. And so I see this aspect of Mercury and Uranus as affirming a sense of us being on the right path. But I do think if we reflect back on our journey over the last 2 months, chances are the right path for us, that sense of beginner's luck, if you will, being with us, has very likely been speaking to us in one way or another over the course of this larger Mercury retrograde season. Now, finally, it is going to be on Wednesday that the sun will change signs and will move into the sign of Leo. So happy birthday month to all the Leos out there. And this tends to represent a time when we collectively move into a space where we're more interested in things like leisurely activities. We focus more on our own sense of connection to what allows us to feel genuinely confident, where it is that we start tapping into that part of us that knows we are worthy of shining and being seen in some way. At the very least, more people become more interested in enjoying themselves and enjoying life. And so I do think that for all of us as a collective, we may very well see ourselves focusing more on our own sense of confidence. Collectively, we'll be celebrating bravery and even celebrity that much more. Wherever it is that people shine bright, that is where we will be directing more of our attention now and in the month ahead. What I love about this week for us, well, look, I am going to say the power of the new moon Well, look, that is a force that will not be denied. And it is important for much of the same reason that the last new moon was important as well. Even though they are certainly distinct energies, they are still connected. They're in the same sign. That alone allows and encourages us to appreciate the connection that is there. But the solar eclipse last month took place at the very beginning of its respective sign. It was like an inspiration, if you will. Now we have this new moon, and given that it is a new moon, it comes with a beginning. However, it's at the very end of its sign, which means hand in hand is a closure. It is happening opposite, with precision, opposite Saturn. And Saturn has to do with limitations and restrictions, and yes, endings as well. So we can see here how, in some ways, this energy is a continuation, but it's also a culmination. It is another chance, but it's also an evaluation as to what chances are worth taking and maybe what it is that has run its course for now. It is in the distinction that we cultivate genuine wisdom. And with Cancerian energy, we are truly asked to listen to ourselves, to listen to our intuition, because it truly knows what pathway is right for us. On a level of emotion, yes, but also on a level of soul. Now, what's right for us, that is about where our greatest learning is, where our greatest sense of not being free of challenge, but our greatest sense of knowing that we are on the path that we are supposed to be. And if it is that our decisions do align us with the right path, the rewards will be there. They will be quick, and they will represent a boost and a streak of good fortune. Well, thank you so much for watching. What do you love about this week? Let me know in the comments below. I love reading you guys. And of course, if you want to know how all this wonderful stuff this week speaks to you and your sign, log on to NadiyaShah.com. Sign up to be one of my superstars. Superstars get expanded exclusive videoscopes each and every week, unlimited access to special horoscopes, and so much more. All of this in the superstar space. I look forward to meeting you there. And Mars special horoscopes are now up. Thank you so much to everybody who downloaded their Mars special horoscope on my website, all the superstars who've been enjoying their Mars special horoscopes as well. Next week, Mars goes into shadow. It is right around the corner. Big moves are taking place. This is an incredibly important alignment to take place. I will be focusing on getting a Mars retrograde special for the collective up on YouTube in the coming days as well. So be on the lookout for that. And preview horoscopes are still available for each and every sign in last week's videoscope and on my Instagram as well. And of course, you can download the full version at NadiyaShah.com. Now, I do have a huge and brand new offering that is being offered through Kepler College, the world-renowned Kepler College. This is a highly respected institution that is recognized as truly exemplary where it comes to astrological education. I am just so grateful, and I feel so honored to have been asked to contribute to their professional development series. And my course, of course, is going to be YouTube for Astrologers, again, as part of their professional development course. And this course, in many ways, it is so deeply fulfilling to me because I take you through so much of what I have learned since being on YouTube, since 2008. I have been on YouTube for a while. And in that time, there are many layers of what I have come to understand, whether that is astrologically, when to launch the best things, how to understand your own chart as to what it is you uniquely bring, whether that is in terms of more personally, in self-development, in creating your channel from the creative side, or also professionally as well, the business side of things, understanding how to reach people, how to create videos that resonate with as many people as you may be meant to. So there's a lot of layers to what I discuss, everything from creating a YouTube plan, like I literally did that in the early days. I created a business plan it outlined so many steps where it came to my YouTube channel and different aspects of what it is that I do as well. That's because I have two planets in Capricorn. But of course, I am very creative as well. I have this whole other creative side of me. I have the intuitive side of me. And so I do think that there may be a whole lot that people out there could gain from seeing this whole other side of me in terms of what it is that I have to teach and what it is that I have to offer. So it's personally brand new for me to offer. It's also, for me, such an honor to be offering it through Kepler College. It is a rare opportunity. Now, space is limited for registration, so please know that it is expected to fill up this class, and space is limited for a reason. That's because part of this class includes mentorship, group mentorship, certainly, and one-on-one as well, carving out that space so that you get that personal look at your YouTube plan from me directly and you get feedback for it. And so I can only do so much as one teacher. And so that is why space is limited on this. It is expected to fill up. You don't have to be an astrologer to participate in this. Anybody who is spiritually minded, spiritually open, wants to have a channel that feels like it aligns with something more meaningful, something like a calling or a spiritual calling, if you will, can benefit from this class. And so if you want to learn more about this incredible new offering, YouTube for Astrologers, and this course, truly one of a kind out there, link is in the description below. I have books as well, as you may know. The Body and the Cosmos and Prayers to the Sky both were number one new releases in New Age Astrology when they first launched. Thank you so much for that. The Body and the Cosmos is me connecting the ideas of Plato to an astrological sky, like the nerd that I am. That's what I did here. And this Prayers to the Sky is a look at the origin myths surrounding the planets. And it also includes astrological magic elements in it as well. And that's been getting a whole lot of great feedback. Now, the universe is wise and loving the nodes of the moon. This book will be available wherever books are sold August 22nd. Very soon, likely this week, will be available for pre-order through Amazon. And be on the lookout for that. If you're on my newsletter, you'll be able to be one of the very first. I'm still trying to figure out what free gift to give to those who do pre-order the book. And so, yes, be on the lookout for that. I hope that you absolutely love this. The advanced copies have all gone out. I've been getting notifications that people have received, and thank you for that. I'm so very grateful to those who got the advanced copy and to those who will go on to pre-order as well. Thank you so much. Now, Synchronicity University is underway as we speak. And it is with Synchronicity University that we are winding up the summer school session. But I'm going to have very big announcements coming up very soon, hopefully later this week. And so again, be on the lookout for that. Join my newsletter so you will be the very first to get that. And you can join my newsletter by going to my website, nadiyashah.com, scroll down. And right there below the homepage, you will be able to see that link to sign up. But yes, I've got some announcements that are going to be coming up. But this week, coming up, I should say, the final class is going to be Mars in aspect. So what a perfect thing to be talking about as we are going to be approaching Mars retrograde season. What a wonderful thing to be discussing. So if you want to learn about Mars in your chart, we already discussed Neptune, we discussed Uranus. If you want to learn about how these planets speak to you in your chart, all of that is available at synchronicityuniversity.com or by clicking the link in the description below. Finally, I have a wonderful partnership with Cosmogram, and along with Cosmogram, I have created custom natal chart readings. And so what you do is you go onto the Cosmogram website, you enter in your data, and within a few hours, you are sent a PDF of my interpretation of your unique birth chart, going through the planets and the different aspects that are there. You can download even a sample reading And so you can have a look at what you can expect so you know exactly what it is you're going to get, except it's going to be for you, uniquely for you. And I love that so many people have gotten this and have loved it. Thank you so much for your trust. And I hope that when you get it, you absolutely love it as well and you cherish it for a very long time to come, that it continues to illuminate your astrological journey. This as well was a dream come true for me because it was getting a computer printout just like this of my chart from my aunt as a teenager that just expanded my mind. It was like me on paper. And that is what got me interested in and got me just so passionate about learning how to read natal charts. That was the very, very beginning. So if it is that you are excited about, want to learn more about my interpretation of your unique birth chart, link is in the description below. And I think that's it for this week. Thank you. Thank you so much for this moment with you. Thank you for your trust. And thank you so much for watching. I'm truly so grateful for it. It'll be a great week. Enjoy.